This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Welcome to this special bulletin on Headlines Now. Is it enough that consensual sex between same-sex couples have been discriminalized now? That is a question that has been cropping up many a time right here in Tamil Nadu, especially with, of course, the Pride Parade in Chennai at the Marina Beach. The minds of people have opened up. Joining me on this special show is Sunil Menon, activist and fashion show director. We'll be discussing the present situation of the LGBT rights, sexual minority rights to be certain. Now, welcome to this special show. I'm Natasha Duraiswamy. Before we take you through the top stories this evening, also a look at the headlines now. DMK Chief Karunanidhi tells the state government to follow the Mamata way by reducing sales tax on fuel, says the centre should not make excuses. A huge relief for the residents of Srirangam constituency as Jayalalitha ensures quick steps taken for the kids' civic issues. Will Lok Ayukta be formed in Tamil Nadu? Be formed in Tamil Nadu, two members of the committee will be identified soon. First Vellore and Namakkal, now Salem district plays witness to a massive head-on collision, 10 die and many left.
Negotiate and the Volvo bus that is from Karnataka, right side on the opposite vehicle.
Experts say it is the street children that are most hooked on the drug abuse, chemical inhalants available cheap over the counter.
None of these other drugs are covered under the NDPS Act. Because they're all, you know, it's all for basically personal use or for domestic use.
On International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Drug Trafficking, the theme this year is to think of your health and not drugs.
Say no to drugs and lead a healthy life and to save the humanity against drugs.
The third annual Rainbow Pride Parade by the LGBT celebrating other sexualities brings solidarity from straight supporters. Well, those were all the top stories from the state. Also a look at the national headlines now. Many would like to hear the Prime Minister step up to the plate and speak up on the Lokpal bill. Chidambaram tells NDTV exclusively. UPA allies NCP and DMK criticise the government for the fuel and gas price hike. The Haryana Congress removes VAT from kerosene. In Delhi, Ramdev visits an injured supporter, hits out at the government. Two more cases of rape reported in Uttar Pradesh. Mayawati says she's being targeted because she's a Dalit. Following allegations of mishandling of funds, a public meet held calls for transparency in Sai Baba Trust dealings. Saina Nehwal loses her Indonesian Open crown to world number 3 Wang Yihan in 3 hard-fought games. Our top story this evening, DMK, a key partner of ruling party UPA, today criticized the hike in fuel prices, saying it would badly hit the middle class and poor, and urged the centre to make efforts to permanently solve the issue. In a statement, he said the centre should not rest by merely defending the hike on some excuse every time the issue arises, but treat it as its utmost duty to completely solve it, as the hike affects the public, especially middle class and people living below poverty line. Karunanidhi also asked the Tamil Nadu government to reduce sales tax on fuel prices, emulating West Bengal government and also as done by his government in the past. Poll promises continued to be met by the Chief Minister, and what better place to start with immediate effect than her own home constituency. Jayalalitha has gone all out to resolve the civic issues brewing in Srirangam. According to a media release, 13 dysfunctional street lights in Subeyapuram village were rectified. Drinking water supply system has also improved after the Chief Minister asked the district collector to take quick steps. A road work is also taken up in the village following public demand and will be over by July 4th. During the Chief Minister's visit to the constituency from June 19th to 21st, she received complaints from the public and is following them up right now. Mm-hmm. On to a very special story brought to you by NDTV Hindu exclusively. Chennai is considered a conservative city, but did you know that everything from designer drugs for the rich kid to over-the-counter inhalants that rag pickers are hooked onto is available on any street in the city? Our reporter Pratiksha Ramkumar found out that cheap alternative of drugs is now becoming a huge struggle for the NGOs to overcome.
4 years ago, 20-year-old Vinod, a mechanic from Tiruvattiyur, used to spend quite a bit of his pocket money on a local variety of gutka and pan. He felt the momentary sense of relaxation was worth it.
இப்ப வந்து ஃப்ரெண்டுங்க கூட சேர்ந்து அவனுங்க வந்து பாக்கல கொட்டி விட்டானுங்க. அதனால கெட்ட பழக்கம் ஆயிடுச்சு. கவுன்சிலிங் எடுத்தாங்க. அதனாலே எல்லாம் கெட்ட பழக்கமும் விட்டேன்.
Other boys are not so lucky. Counselors say what begins with pan quickly shifts to tobacco, marijuana, and even chemical inhalants. In fact, NGOs say that street children are the most hooked.
We find them in a later stage when they are really addicted to the core, then it's not very easy to rehabilitate them. They should take the decision that they have to come out of it. Since they don't have parents or they are not all the time under some adult supervision.
Most chemical inhalants popular with street children are available over the counter at most departmental stores at prices between 14 to 100 rupees. No wonder today's rag picker can afford and thrive on the drug abuse. In fact, the most used chemical inhalants are aerosol sprays, spray paint, deodorant, and hair sprays, vegetable oil cooking sprays and static cling sprays. Nitrites, room deodorizers and capsules that release vapors when opened. Volatile solvents like thinners, nail polish removers, fevicols and fuels. And gases like medical gases, cream dispensers and propane lighters. If sniffed or snorted regularly, the most affected parts are the brain and the nervous system.
They can cause lung infections or they can cause inflammation inside the oral cavity. While inhalation, they can cause ulcers in the nose and all.
That's not all. None of these addictive substances are banned by the law. But are these harmful chemical inhalants really prohibited?
Under the NDPS Act, only the ganja is covered. But here, because of the easy availability of these pharmaceutical drugs across the counter, where there's nobody goes very strictly about checking the prescriptions or checking the, you know, whether the person requires so much of drugs or not.
It's counseling at rehab centers that top the cure list, along with medicines that help reduce withdrawal symptoms and bouts of depression. But experts say it is awareness that the most vulnerable people lack.
Best way is we have to educate about the ill effects of the drugs. And we have to catch them at the starting of their drug use.
NGOs dealing with street children have mainly been concentrating on youth camps and clubs to tackle the main issue being peer pressure. But with street children lacking strong familial influence, complete rehabilitation of hardcore addicts is still the tallest mountain to climb. In Chennai, with camera person Arun, this is Pratiksha Ramkumar for NDTV Hindu.
Now, speaking of drug abuse, today is International Anti-Drug Abuse and Illicit Drug Trafficking Day, and people from all walks of life went on a rally to support this. This year's theme was Think Health, Not Drugs, bringing about an awareness on the harmful effects of drug abuse and also what the parents, teachers should do in this particular situation.
மாணவர்கள்லாம் வந்து அந்த விளம்பர தட்டிகள் அதாவது சே நோ டு ட்ரக்ஸ் லீட் எ ஹெல்த்தி லைஃப் இப்போ ட்ரக் எடுக்கிறதுனால என்ன விபரீதங்கள் ஏற்படும் அப்படின்றத ஒரு பொதுமக்களுக்கு ஒரு விழிப்புணர்வு ஏற்படுத்துறதுக்காக இந்த ஒரு ரேலி அதே மாதிரி என்ஃபோர்ஸ்மெண்ட் பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் மாநில அளவில் வந்து போதை தடுப்பு பொருள் வந்து தீவிரமாக நடவடிக்கை எடுத்து இந்த கஞ்சா ஹெராயின் அந்த பவுடர் அந்த ஸ்கூல்ஸ் காலேஜஸ் இதெல்லாம் கான்சன்ட்ரேட் பண்ணுறது பண்ணிகிட்டு இருக்காங்க ஸோ இந்த ஒரு விழிப்புணர்வு மூலம் நம்ம சொல்கிறது என்னென்னா சே நோ டு ட்ரக்ஸ் அண்ட் லீட் எ ஹெல்த்தி லைஃப் அண்ட் டு சேவ் த ஹியூமனிட்டி அகெயின்ஸ்ட் ட்ரக்ஸ்
Now here's a question we're all asking, will Lokayukta be set up in Tamil Nadu too? The president of Right to Information Movement on June 6th presented a memorandum to the Tamil Nadu Chief Minister to set up a Lokayukta. Subsequently, a three-member team of the Right to Information Movement also met the Karnataka Lokayukta Santosh Hegde to guide them in the process of preparation of suggestion to Lokayukta Act. Now, based on that Right to Information Movement's president, John Lopez today met Justice V.R. Krishna Iyer in Cochin and requested to be in the draft committee, to which he agreed. Other members of the committee will be identified soon and the process will be completed in 2 weeks' time. Coming up on the other side of this short break, a very special discussion and a story, Rainbow in the Sky, as the LGBT supporters join the Pride Parade. Stay with us for the colours at the Marina Beach.